can't breathe. 999. Waiting for the exhale. I toss my pain with my wishes in a wishing well.
Well, welcome back to the Good Boys Podcast. I'm Brett. This is Todd. Today's guest.
We are here with Boof. Spoof.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the guy that beat up KSI in a boxing match. Vinnie Hacker.
You have Heyman and Vinnie.
Okay, his brother.
KSI. Nah, dude. If I fought KSI, I would have been done for.
It was a lot. Just going through that whole process was a lot. Just really training. Like not so much stressful, but like just like. Like, I was doing so many things at the time. It was, like, training for boxing.
Yeah.
And I'm also, like, streaming at the same time. And I was also shooting, like, that Netflix show at the same time. So I was doing, like, all three things. So it would be leaving at 4 in the morning to go to L.A. to box, come back, shoot the Netflix show, be done with that about 9 p.m., and then I'd stream until, like, 4 a.m.
Jesus.
So and then box at 4 a.m.
It's important to prioritize your mental health and wellness every day. When you work on yourself, it brings positive change in all areas of your life. There's no better time to invest in yourself than right now. Talkspace lets you send and receive unlimited messages with your dedicated therapist in a Talkspace platform 24/7. Talkspace has thousands of licensed therapists with years of experience. As a listener of this podcast, you'll get $100 off your first month with Talkspace. To match with a licensed therapist today, go to Talkspace.com and make sure to use the code GOODBOYS, G-O-O-D-B-O-Y-S. Make sure to use the code GOODBOYS to get $100 off your first month and show support for our show. That's GOODBOYS, G-O-O-D-B-O-Y-S at Talkspace.com.
Most heavy schedule.
God,
I guess not so stream until 4 a.m., but like I would like stream late as hell and like get like only a few hours of sleep and just like
the die. Show is the hype out show, right?
Yeah.
How long did this routine go on for, the schedule?
What, like 4 months?
Jeez. Longer.
Was it?
Like six.
Well, because I started training like February.
Well, because I would always ask you to come skate and you'd be like, no, I can't. And then that went on for like 6 months. And I was just like, wow. I was like, damn, we're not homies. and then I found out like you were doing the boxing thing.
Oh yeah.
Like way later, and I was like, oh okay, like that makes sense.
Wait, how did you guys meet?
We met at a skate park, right? Yeah,
We met Halloween bombing a hill.
Oh yeah, we were all bombing a hill on Halloween and
bombing on a skateboard.
You want to tell them that story?
You want me to tell them it?
Yeah. Okay. Go ahead. So, I mean it was your experience.
Yeah, no, that was bad. You guys know where like Kith is, right?
Yeah.
Like that hill, La Cienega.
Yeah.
Huge.
Right next to Fred Siegel's.
Exactly. I'm at the top of it and I was like, yo, I'm going to like bomb the hill. And I was like, I need people to check for cars because there's two lights. And
what year is this?
This was like 2 years ago.
Year and a half. Yeah, 2 years. Yeah. Year and a half.
Cool. So him and one of my old roommates went down there to the second light, and then his homie was watching the first one. I was like, okay, cool, I'm gonna like just straight line it. And I yelled him dropping, and his friend was just on his phone on the sidewalk.
not checking for the cars.
Yeah, light turned green, cars started coming.
He was dead ass just like going like this through the cars. I was looking at it because I was at the bottom yelling at my buddy that was supposed to be watching that first light for him. I was like, Yo! Yeah.
And then this kid just sees me like fly by him. And he's just like looks up and I'm just like, dude.
Yeah.
And then I get to the bottom of the hill and I just like mugged him the whole night.
I don't know why that's the thing that confused me. I don't know why he mugged me.
Guilty by association.
I was at the bottom yelling at him.
Did you know who he was before?
No, not really.
You're just mugging some random dude who you thought almost killed you.
Yeah, and then he hit me up like 2 weeks later to skate. We went to a skate park. Well, I was like napping on my couch. I gave him the wrong address to a park that was like 30 minutes away.
Oh, no.
Nice. And no payback.
He drove to the other park, and I was just like, yo, where are you? I'm here. He's like, dude, it's rush hour. And I'm like, my fault. And then we skated.
You're like, wrong park, pussy.
Yeah, exactly.
So we started skating at like 7 p.m.
Yeah, dude, it was bad.
Like, we were supposed to get there at like 5.
Yeah.
And then it was already like sunset.
My fault.
All good.
Is this the first time he's apologized to you?
No, definitely. Definitely have apologized.
Damn, and so Boof, I've skated with Boof before. We used to drop in.
Is that what they call you?
You know?
Yeah.
Boof?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know why?
Why?
Because he hides drugs up his butt.
Yeah. Well, no. No.
Just kidding. I'm young.
If I had to, but no.
No, I took. Roof, he told me a story in confidence. Jumps. I'm sorry about that.
But damn.
It's bad weed here, but it's good weed
in the Kansas Midwest. City. Yeah, in Kansas City, it meant good weed, and I was like a little stoner skater, and then moved out here and found out it meant bad weed, but like good skater. So like. Worked itself out.
Yeah, that's cool.
For the most part.
And you guys are both, where are you from?
I'm from Seattle.
Oh, Seattle.
Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
Yeah.
Grunge rock area, right?
You have that Seattle vibe.
Yeah,
you do.
Yeah, a little fucking.
Oh, yeah. Dude, Seattle's so moody. It's so bipolar, too. It's like, that's like.
Really puts you in your feels.
I've like talked to people about this. Like, it's like a, in my opinion, it's like a good place to like visit and like go back to when you're like older and maybe like, you know, end up like living there when you're older. But like to grow up there,
yeah,
it can be kind of like rough depending on like your personality because like it's so like gloomy there.
Fuck. Like every day, right?
It's like, yeah. I mean, like when I was growing up, even in the summer, like that shit was like raining like 60 degrees out.
Damn.
And it was just pouring down rain. And it was just like, dude, it was like gloomy. It was so like, just, I don't know. And plus like my school was like an hour away.
Why?
By like bus, like taking like somebody taking me and carpooling with me. It was only like 30, 25, but okay. Like I had to take the bus every morning. Cause my parents were like working all the time. So I'd have to get up at like 4:30 in the morning. Cause I was also playing sports, take the bus an hour and then do morning workouts for my sport. And then I have school for the rest of the day, and then I practice after.
You've things. Always had like
I didn't even used know to this. That's so intense.
Yeah. Yeah,
it was
fucking horrendous. Hell.
It was fun though. It was fun.
What did you play in high school?
I played baseball and then football for 2 years.
Did you skate in high school?
I did towards the end of high school.
Not for the team, but you know.
Yeah, for the we had a skate team. Yeah. A little skate team.
I was like a pop shove sponsor me vid.
Oh yeah,
this high school sponsor me vid goes crazy. I'm telling you,
that shit goes nuts.
Well, you made a sponsor me video.
Huh?
You made
that'd be so funny though.
I started actually skating when I started skating with him.
Yeah.
Like I didn't like skate.
Were you nervous to skate with him? Because he's really good.
Oh, thanks.
I mean, I guess I was a little bit, because like, especially when you first start out skating or like kind of transitioning into getting better.
Yeah.
Like you feel a lot of pressure going to like skate parks and stuff. Like, especially when you like, I go to skate with him and all his homies would be at the skate park. Who were also really good. So like I'd show up and there'd be like 10 dudes popping like trays down like a 10 stair. And I'm just like,
you're like smacking your board. Like, nice.
Yeah.
Like, I can get a tray flip.
Yup.
Yeah.
He's just there for support.
Ew.
Yeah. He actually got two clips in the Sonder video with Bubba. In our full length video, like a while.
Oh, really?
That came out last year. Yeah.
What were the clips of? Like,
they were both. So one was just like a shove 5-0.
Yeah.
And then on a ledge, and then just another one was just a shove down like a 3-block. But then we had to stop getting clips because
it's boxing.
Because I started training for boxing, I couldn't get like risk getting hurt.
Yeah.
So I had to stop. I only got two clips. I was gonna try to tray down a 6.
Yeah, we had one. We had one set up for you. Yeah,
I was so on the 5-0 clip.
I forgot about that. Yeah.
Yeah, I was supposed to tray off of a 6 after that, and the shove 5-0 that I got was like kind of like sketchy. So I like stopped there because
it was like,
and I was like, I can't believe
you
got
were
that.
You were so stoked. Like it was like, dude, one of those, like never, instant celebrations.
And
like,
the thing is too is that like I have never even done like a ledge trick ever.
Yeah.
Like I didn't even know how to like 5-0. I didn't know how to like just pop an ollie into a 5-0 and come off.
Dude, have faith in Bubba.
For real.
Yeah. Is Bubba coaching you? Bubba's your guys' friend, right?
Who also skates. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's pretty sick.
Bubba shot. So I did a video for Gothic Mocha's skate team.
Yeah.
And it was like the Tony Hawk, like little switcheroo, like back in the day. Yeah. Not the Tony Hawk. No, Owen Wilson.
Yeah. Owen Wilson, Eric Hoskins.
You can't skate Owen Wilson video.
Oh, so I saw that. That was amazing.
Yeah. So he's in it. Boof is in it.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
And so Bubba was filming it.
Yeah.
And then, have you seen the video? It's like a little switcheroo video.
Maybe. Have you shown it to me?
I've shown it to you.
Okay. Then yes.
So like we had to get like this like one clip in one shot, and so I had to like do like what, like 20 sprints,
dude. Yeah, you were behind a wall and then you hopped behind a wall and then you sprinted around, but there was like a shadow, so we had to like film it weird.
Because I can't skate, so someone else was like doing the tricks for me,
Oh, really?
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But it was like filmed so perfectly that like you couldn't tell that it was
him. Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah.
So it's just killed like you can't see his head.
Yeah, exactly.
Exposed you, but that's pretty fucking cool.
Yeah, right? Thanks, dude.
dude, best switch front side flip I've ever seen. Dude.
That's this guy. That was, this
that
guy.
Was
me, right?
Yeah.
Dude,
that
was a you movie. Showed it to me. You said you told me that was
Oh,
you.
I told you it was me?
Yeah.
Oh, I never told you it wasn't me?
No,
oh,
never told
oh,
me.
Dude,
we
oh, dude.
Damn it. We ruined it.
I thought you knew.
I thought you could skate this whole time.
Dude. I mean, I used to skate. I mean, I used to skate first when I was, you know, younger.
Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah.
Man, so I'm funny. Terrible now.
That's so funny.
I have like I have videos up on YouTube from when I was like 8 years old of me just dropping in on a half pipe. Dude, that's it. It's just me going
just
like
drop.
I drop in, get to the coping of the other side, and just pick up my board and then drop in again.
Do it again.
And it's going for like 2 minutes, and there's like 10 videos.
Wait, did you
just that I posted that. When I was
that's
like,
rad.
Like
that's so
hell
funny.
Yeah, I need to see that.
Wait, did you ever see the videos my dad posted of me when I was 8 years old? I was like 7 or 8 trying to ride a dirt bike. Ever see that?
I think so.
So my dad's friend was like had a like 7, 8 year old son, and he was like gnarly on a dirt bike. Like he could do these crazy jumps. And my dad was like, my son is gonna be a dirt biker too. Like he thought I had it in me. So he went and bought me like a 50cc, like a little blue Toyota dirt bike.
Yamaha.
Yeah, it was crazy. And he like
Toyota dirt bike.
I don't know. It was Yamaha, whatever. It was crazy. I lived in Chicago and he would take me up to these trails in Wisconsin, but I was horrible. I would like be wobbly and I would fall over. So my dad would like videotape everything. I was going and I didn't see another one coming.
Ooh.
And it T-boned me.
What?
That was like how my career as a dirt biker ended. But years later, my dad like spliced together a compilation video like that.
Sick.
Looked like it would have been for like it's like sponsor me type of video, but it was just me like 10 seconds of me like going really fast over a jump and then just eating shit.
Yeah,
it was just like a bunch of videos of me falling for a couple minutes. I'll show. I still have it. It's so funny.
Good for you, man. But that made you happy and sad. Huh?
It was
for you, happy and healthy.
Oh,
song stuck in my head.
Yeah.
It's my bad. Whenever I have a song stuck in my head, I just gotta
fucking just keeps going.
Sing it, you know?
Just keeps going, yeah.
Huh? Do you know that? You know that song, right?
Yeah. No, it's lit.
Yeah, it's a fucking great record.
Oh, I love it.
Have you like had it sang to you in person before?
No, just on stage. And I was sitting there fist pumping. I went to her concert.
Backstage?
You went to an Olivia Rodrigo concert?
No, I was actually in the middle.
Oh, shit.
Dude, when I walked in, I got like mobbed by like so many fucking people.
Uh-huh.
Where was this?
Where was that?
Greek?
You know what? Yeah.
Okay, cool.
I wasn't there. So,
I wasn't there either. Sorry.
I feel like you're just behind him. Just like, no.
Yeah. I'm like, I see him right there.
But I got in there, dude. And, like, I couldn't even, like, enter, like, to give, like, the security people my ticket because so many people just came up to me and started, like, asking me for pictures. And I feel really bad to say, like I can't say no to people.
Yeah.
So I'm sitting there and there's, like, a shit ton of people around me. And I'm just, like it totally, like, just went through my head that, like, there are going to be a lot of teenage girls at this concert. And I was just, like...
This is at the Olivia Rodrigo concert.
Yeah. Yeah. And I was stuck there and there were so many people fucking surrounding me. I saw people from like the like different areas of like that stadium just getting up out of their seat and trying to come towards me. And I was like, oh God.
You just made the show about you.
And then you had Max in a top hat,
green
blazer,
Max over
and a
there,
sweater.
He had a top hat. Here, let me pull up the picture, bro.
It's
Max your hometown
sweater.
Friend?
Yeah.
Or just a really good
friend? Well, I met him on video games, like...
Oh, hell yeah.
Like, not too long ago, and then... But he's from Seattle, so...
Dude, it's the funniest photo.
Wait, so this concert was last week, right? A couple weeks ago?
Last week?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait, let me pull up this picture right here. Look at him. I told him to
pull up. Oh, fuck. That's a sick outfit.
So it's just them two. Wow.
Damn, bro. Max, you look good.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
You too.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
But... And then also when I walked in, like, and when I started walking towards my seat, like, the whole, like, crowd just started, like, yelling. Like, I thought Olivia came out.
No, they were cheering you on, dude.
But, like, yeah.
They were cheering for you?
I don't know why. But I was just like.
You fucking knocked out Deji.
Yeah. Yeah, that's why. They were like,
yeah! That's awesome.
Just but over I was a just year so later.
Confused. Like, I started looking towards the stage and I was just like, she's not coming out. Like, I don't know Are why everybody's screaming. I'm actually pretty good friends with her. I met her like
sick.
Like 8 months ago at my friend's birthday party. Quinn. You know Quinn, right?
Oh, I love Quinn. Yeah. Quinn Blackwell.
Yeah.
She's the best.
And she also knows like a few, like Jack, she knows Jack, and that's how I like meet a lot of people actually, is him and my buddy Jack, because I don't go out a lot. Nice. Like I'm like
that's good,
either playing games 24/7 or working out or
working boxing, on cars,
working on cars.
Boxing.
Nice, or just like going out in the middle of the night and just trying to fight random people because I'm bored. So like I'll like go in an alleyway with like a mask on and just start like
vigilante
fight.
But
like just to anybody though. You know, you start out with like high schoolers and then you work your way up towards like adult men,
old men,
like
us.
Like adult, adult men.
If you had to guess our ages, what would you guess?
Please don't try to fight us though.
It'd just be him. I'm just gonna, like, I'll just film it for World Star.
You don't have to be generous either.
Like late 20s?
I'll take it. I'm fucking, I just turned 31 in April.
Hey.
And I'm 29. So I guess.
Congrats.
That's right. That's like, thank you. Congrats, it's a big milestone.
Yeah,
it's
huge.
There you go.
Okay, I thought I'd be married with kids by now. But so did you get like a free concert ticket when you went to the show? That's nice.
That's nice of her.
And we were sitting next to this one dude that like I didn't know who he was. But he like, we just started like, you know, her songs are like, they're not like, it's not like Denzel Curry's up there. Like, her songs are good, but it's not like, it's like people are getting hyped to it and like like fucking like fist pumping and shit. But me, Max, and that dude were sitting there fucking going like this like the whole time.
That's so
we're,
like,
hype. Screaming and shit too. And we were like all pointing at her. We were like, yeah. And she was just like, she like looked at us once, like our group, and she was just like,
she just, probably like, was like, chill.
And I was like, okay, I should probably stop.
No, keep going. That happens. Keep going.
Dude, I was like, it would be so funny if she just started laughing, but I'm like, yeah, I can't do that to her. That'd be so funny though.
That'd be so worth it.
Damn.
Oh yeah.
My best friend in the music business just started managing her.
So. Oh really? That's dope.
So he's like the best dude ever.
Hey, Interscope?
No, he's her manager. Label.
My friend Christiana from high school actually worked with her at Interscope. So shout to Christiana. You did it. Wherever you are.
Sick.
Yeah, that's sick. Sick. Do you have any boxing matches coming up?
Dude, I don't know. I like, well, I've had like people like come to me and be like, hey, would you like to box again? I'm like, there's a lot of stuff that went down that last boxing match and didn't go smoothly.
You game too, right?
Yes.
So you guys both game?
Yeah.
You game together? Or
no.
Like stream? No.
What do you guys play?
We do sometimes.
Yeah. Sometimes. If it's like anything that's like not Valorant,
Yeah.
You play Valorant?
Mm-hmm.
What do you play?
Valorant.
How is Valorant? I've only played once.
You guys play Valorant.
It's aggravating.
Really?
As hell. Like if you're not playing for like, like I said, obviously still play for fun, but if you're like trying to like rank up and stuff like that, dude, it gets you so mad.
Well, no, because like I get so stoked when I get like, when I hit gold. Yeah. Meanwhile, you're immortal, and I'm just like, I'll like send you like a picture of like my game or whatever. I'm like, dude, I'm so stoked right now, and you're just like, yeah, you are, buddy. Like it just feels like my dad's just like patting me on my back.
Are you really good at Valorant?
I'm pretty decent, yeah. Nice. But dude, that game will give you some mental issues, I'm telling you.
Yeah, I'm sure. I mean, I
wanted to throw my fucking keyboard across the room so many times, dude. I went off camera one time and just like
yelled,
just screamed. Like I was like, I just got up, got out of frame, and just started screaming as I was like,
just like mute your mic or what?
Yeah, I was just like, fuck.
You do Twitch?
Yeah.
What's your channel name?
Vinny.
Oh, that's sick. Nice. How'd you get that?
There's a dude that had it, but he hasn't like been on Twitch in like 3 years. So I was like, hey.
Yeah.
Can I get his name?
That's sick.
Brett and I game. We play together sometimes. We play Fortnite.
Actually, this podcast is probably a product of us doing Twitch and playing Fortnite together. And we just were like, wow, we have a lot of fun talking for long periods of time about nothing. Let's do a podcast.
Sick.
But it's
basically us.
This used to be my streaming room, and like we would just play Fortnite all day.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Like during the pandemic. It was really fun.
Oh, hell yeah. That's what I'd just be on Valorant during the pandemic the whole time.
And I wish I would have hopped on Valorant. I think earlier. Like fucking late. Yeah.
Yeah. That's how I feel.
It's kind of hard to get into it right now.
Yeah.
I feel like because there's like, I don't know, a lot has changed ever since like it, for, like everybody first started playing.
And there's so much hype behind it right now.
Yeah.
Like every pro team just like going through whatever they're going through. And yeah, then Twitch is just like blowing it up even more.
Really?
Yeah.
Have you played Apex Legends?
Yeah, Max actually got me into it.
Okay,
is that fun? Max is actually really good, but I was playing it the other day, and dude, that game is like, it's like I'd make so many mistakes in that game that I'd like usually, like how you strafe in Valorant is different from how you strafe in like Apex and shit, and like aim is the same way. So I got in the game, I was like, I have pretty good aim, I have pretty good movement, I should be fine. I get in there, I'm getting shit on.
Yeah.
Like, oh, hell yeah.
I feel like I'm so behind just playing Fortnite. And like, there's so many like new games and like better games that people are playing.
I mean, how people still play it though.
Yeah.
A lot of streamers that like mainly stream other games, they'll like, if they want to just chill, they'll like stream Fortnite and just chill and talk to friends and shit. Yeah. So.
Are you homies with like Courage and Nadeshot?
Yeah.
I love those guys.
Those guys are the funniest.
And they're just so good at everything.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Oh, yeah. Like, I don't know how
it's fucked up.
Like, how do you get that good? Like, I guess
at every game, right? Yeah, it's insane.
So I first started playing Fortnite in 2018. Started streaming, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And then broke up. My girlfriend at the time broke up with me, and then she started dating the number one Fortnite player in the world. And so I just stopped. I stopped for like 2 years because I couldn't go on there and play. I would just get shit on, you know? Yeah. It's fucked up.
Yeah.
So don't date anybody that's like, that might date a streamer.
We got you.
It's like,
got you.
It's like you guys aren't friends and your girl breaks up with you and then she starts dating Vinny.
Yeah.
Like, it's fucked up.
We always laugh though. Like,
you have to quit.
Every once in a while though, we'll be playing in a comment. I would
never play Valorant again, honestly.
Yeah, you probably quit skating too. Yeah.
It's so funny. Yeah. Every once in a while we see comments that are like, yeah, she went from the worst Fortnite player in the world to the best. Like, we're not that bad, but we're definitely not pro.
Oh, shit.
It's really funny. I played for the first time yesterday in like 3 months.
Yeah, sometimes Brett, we'll play and he'll spiral and just like have a fucking freak out.
If I'm just like hitting a rut, I'll quit for like a month or two. I have to take
That was me the past month with Valorant.
Yeah.
I literally had the worst games of my life and I was just like, I'm done. I was like, I quit.
Yeah.
I needed like a
didn't go on
reset.
My computer. Yeah.
I didn't even open the app.
Yeah. No, I literally couldn't. I would like look at it on my PC and I was just like, yeah, not today.
It's important to prioritize your mental health and wellness every day. When you work on yourself, it brings positive change in all areas of your life. The long-term effects of therapy can give you the tools to deal with challenges as they arise, strengthen your relationships, and give you a more positive outlook on life. There's no better time to invest in yourself than right now. Talkspace lets you send and receive unlimited messages with your dedicated therapist in a Talkspace platform 24/7. With Talkspace, you set goals with your therapist and they hold you accountable and make sure you're really progressing. Therapy can help you shift your perspective, find tools to cope in difficult times, and be a guiding light. Talkspace is the number one online therapy platform that has thousands of licensed therapists trained in over 40 specialties, including anxiety, depression, relationships, and more. Your therapist can help you set and achieve your goals. Talkspace is a fraction of the cost of in-person therapy. Instead of waiting for an appointment, you can send unlimited messages to your therapist 24/7 and they'll engage with you daily, 5 days a week. Talkspace has thousands of licensed therapists with years of experience. As a listener of this podcast, you'll get $100 off your first month with Talkspace. To match with a licensed therapist today, go to Talkspace.com and make sure to use the code GOODBOYS, GOODBOYS. Make sure to use the code GOODBOYS to get $100 off your first month and show support for our show. That's GOODBOYS, GOODBOYS at Talkspace.com.
So what's next for you guys? Like, I mean, you guys are both pretty young, nice careers. Do you make music too?
Just for fun.
I feel like you'd crush it on stage.
I just like kind of like, so me and my buddy Adam have like made a few songs together and like obviously have like a few like scrapped and like drafted or whatever, need to like edit more and stuff like that. But like, I just make it for fun. Like, we make it on his like laptop.
Mm-hmm. Like GarageBand?
Yeah. Like that. Well, like he has like the program on his laptop and everything.
Like Logic or something.
And we'll like, And we just record on there just because it's like, sick. It's fun to go through the whole process because, like, for the first, like, maybe 2 hours, you're just, like, fucking around and throwing, like, stupid lyrics in there. And then, you know, it turns into, like, actually trying. And it's a really fun thing to do, like, especially when you're with your homie and you both are just, like, fucking around and doing whatever. So I just post it just to do it.
Do you date? Do you, like, go on dates?
Do I?
Yeah.
Hell no.
Streams a lot.
Dude, I think the only time... The only reason I've been going, this is the most I've gone out. Like, these past 2 weeks is the most I've gone out in probably like a year.
It's
and I've gone out like 3 times.
Damn. What's like, yeah. when I was, because you're like, what, 20?
I'm 19.
19. When I was, when I was 24 and I moved to LA, I was just like raging.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And like going out a lot. And like I was surrounded, I guess it was like the people I was surrounded with too.
Yeah.
Like everyone I was with, it was like going out and partying.
Yeah.
And like, you know, like kind of like a repeat. So I think like you're fucking doing it great.
Yeah.
Like not
yeah.
going out and wasting your time and like wasting your money on beers and bitches, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was a cougar hunter when I was 19.
Yeah, you were.
Yeah.
I still am.
What's the oldest you've gone?
35.
Really?
Damn. When I was 19, I was 37, dude.
Damn.
Oh, yo, let's go.
Wait, tell us about this 35-year-old, though. What happened? What's the story behind it?
So, I mean, I think that, like, I met her through, like, my friend's friend, and it was my friend's friend's mom. So...
She just had a kid really young.
Yeah, opportunity presented itself.
Yeah, and I just went over and then like,
my God.
I was just chilling with the two of them. They went out to eat and then it was just me and the mom.
And nice. Who made the first move?
It was their stepmom though, obviously, because like,
wait, so
the kid's not fucking like 9 or anything. Like my friend's friend isn't 9, but yeah. It was her stepmom and her dad was like 50.
Wait, she get they're divorced?
Huh?
They're divorced?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, now.
Yeah.
Now. No, yeah, they were divorced.
Okay.
I have too much PTSD from cheating to make somebody cheat on another person.
Oh, you got cheated
cheat
on
like, well, like fucking high school.
Oh, okay.
Like so it's like it's just like fucking high school love or whatever.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I was dating that girl for maybe like 8 couple months.
Oh. A couple days. Like since like couple last days. Period.
Yeah. I fell in love with her after a couple days and I was just heartbroken. It hurt me.
Look at now. I bet she's regretting that, huh?
Dude, I don't know. She went like AWOL, but she, yeah, she's gone. She like she doesn't have Instagram or anything anymore.
Good for her. Ruined her life.
Yeah, I don't know.
She's like, I don't want to see it.
I'm sure she's happy now.
She cheated on me because I wouldn't have sex with her when I was like 14.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
That's okay. Dark.
Really yeah.
Really dark.
And she was like, I think at the time, because I was like, I was a young freshman,
uh-huh.
and she was a sophomore? Yeah. And she was like 16 or something like that. And she was just like, no, I'm cheating on you because you want to have sex with me. And I was like, for sure.
Oh, my God.
And it was a dude.
What is going on in Seattle?
She cheated on me with a dude at my school that played on the football team that was like a 225-pound like lineman. And I was like,
oh, my God.
Now you got it, bro. I was like, you got it.
How does your because you're from KC, right?
Yeah.
So your family's like cool with you guys being out here and doing your thing?
Yeah.
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 Stoked.
I moved to LA like 2 days after I turned 18.
Damn.
Were you already like doing well on TikTok when you moved out here?
Not really. Like I was like at that time that I was like that I had just moved out here, there were like guys that had like I had like 800,000 followers or something like that. And there were guys with like 20 million and like shit that I was like moving out with.
Who were some of those guys?
It was like Griffin. I moved in with Griffin. This kid, Keo, Quentin.
Quentin lived at that house?
For a little bit, yeah. And we were there for like 2 months until like everybody just disbanded. And then I got thrown into a random house.
Yeah.
Are you still homies with them?
I mean, we're like, I don't really hang out with anybody. I mean, they're still like homies, but like I just like haven't seen them. I don't see them a lot because I live like an hour away. Mm-hmm. Nobody's going to want to fucking drive an hour. Yeah. And I don't blame him for it. I'm like, dude, don't mission. Fucking...
Like way in the valley, right?
Oh, yeah.
Did you... What was the second house you moved into?
It was a house in Studio City. It wasn't like a actual...
Wait,
like,
it was my house? Yeah, old was house, it? Maybe? It was like up in the hill?
Yeah.
A little bit?
Yeah.
Altaview?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That so was that's my house. What
I
was
asking. Wait, yeah. Yo.
I lived there before.
Damn.
When I met Todd, that was his house.
That's crazy.
So we were in there.
Okay. Yeah, my room was... Go upstairs, go to the right, on the very right, facing, like, had the window to the street.
Yep, that was mine.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Oh Jesus.
Well, you guys had the same bedroom. That's crazy.
Damn, someone died in there.
Hey.
Nah, I'm just kidding.
Wait, oh, damn.
But
I was about to say.
That would have made his life right there.
Dude, I was about to say, because one night, like, I had all my homies chilling in my room, and we saw something, like, you know that little, like, how you look out the window and there's that roof, like, right under it?
Yeah.
We, like, saw, like, something, like, crawling, like a fucking, like, beast or something,
really?
Bro. And I was like tweaking.
Crazy. Jesus.
I think we were all higher than that.
Probably.
But I would like looked out and I was like, oh hell no.
Just freaking out.
Yeah.
Damn. I used to think spirits would like follow me. If, like I'm from Huntington, so like long story short, my ex-girlfriend's house was haunted. Or like, I thought it was. Okay. And I was convinced there was a spirit following me from like her house to my parents' house up to LA.
Damn.
So, dude, I don't know if it made it to Altaview, but
it might have.
It could have. It sounds like it did.
Because we also thought we had a, like a stalker. Like we'd see a, like a person out in the backyard.
There was a stalker there for sure.
We had one time we had a party and we had a guy. He's a driver, like old, like chubby, like old man, and he just walked into our house, like straight into our house.
What?
And then like we like, went to go kick him out and like we're like threatening him. He's like, I'm not fucking leaving. I want to fucking party with you guys. And it was super strange. So ever since that like that happened, I thought he was like stalking our house. And like, yeah, those were the fucking days. That was before the pandemic. Everyone got. Yeah. Are you like making any skate movies like for in the future? And are you gonna be in one?
Is I'm gonna try
Dude,
to be.
I'm trying to get you to get like come out and get clips.
Yeah.
But Bubba and I are filming something right now. Uh-huh. Don't know what it's for yet. Nice. And then hopefully something after that.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have like any sponsors like for that or like how does?
Dude, just still.
Still?
Just still.
You still have? Oh, yeah,
still. Yeah.
Still skateboards is like the one we with the GM video.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
But just them, hopefully.
Is it all like all street or like street and vert like mixed in?
For the still video that just came out,
yeah,
that was like just street.
Uh-huh.
And this one, it's like more like I get to do whatever I want with it. Yeah. So it's going to be everything that I can possibly throw myself at.
And when did you first start skateboarding?
When I was 5.
Is what your parents put you on the board or did you, it was like
no something? I was like dude I wanted like a skateboard so bad because I saw Tony Hawk do like the 900
on
like an X Games recap and I was like I'm doing that like there's nothing stopping me from doing that. Went to Walmart, got like a Spider-Man skateboard and just started going.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it was the best thing
when did
ever.
You realize like you actually were really good?
Dude, like I never thought I was like that good.
I usually was like, really good.
Like, I started going, my local skate park was like 2.5 hours from my house. And my parents were like down to take me there once. And I went there and I killed it in front of like the owner or the manager or whatever. And he's just like, yeah, dude, if you want to come back, like free sessions. I was like, oh, sick. So I'd go back every weekend for like years.
Your parents would just drive you 2.5 hours.
Yeah, because like my friends that I met there, like their parents would take them. So like, my parents hung out with their parents, and then it was cool. Just like homies.
That's so sick. Fun.
We would all go on like trips together and stuff.
Culture.
Yeah, exactly. Hang out. Yeah, it was the best thing ever. But
damn.
Yeah.
And then when did you move to LA again?
4 years ago. That's when I was awesome. 20. Yeah.
Are you guys gonna stay in LA forever?
I don't plan on it.
No, I don't plan on it either.
If you could go anywhere, where would you guys go?
I would go back to Washington.
Really?
This is beautiful. Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Dude, New York.
New York.
New York.
New York City.
Yeah. That's love cool. New York.
Brooklyn?
Fuck yeah.
Yeah. I mean, that'd be sick. I just like the skating out there. Because it's like raw. It's like gnarly.
It's a little different than out here, right?
Yeah, yeah. Because every skate spot out here is like perfect.
Uh-huh.
But there, it's like, dude, you got to work
you
for it.
You need to like be a little artistic with it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So.
Dude, what's that spot in Washington? It's like San Juan Islands?
Yeah.
Have you been there before?
No, I haven't. I've been wanting to. Wait, which, are you talking about the park or a spot?
Is it? I guess the park. I mean,
there's like one park. I can't remember if it's San Juan Islands or whatever, but it has like a crazy, like, dude, it's like giant. And it's like, wait, let me see.
But it's like right on the water, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, actually I looked up that place today, San Juan Islands, and it's fucking just beautiful.
Yeah.
And, like you see a bunch of orcas when you're like, when you're out there.
That's sick.
You know, killer whales.
Yeah.
You gotta watch out for the orcas.
Yeah.
Dude. Yeah. I usually like when I go there, I like skate out of the bowl. Like pop out,
okay.
And then
so there's like
and
a
then a whale,
right,
and then a whale blows out of its little hole there, and then
that's
I
sick.
Do like a 360, and then it launches me back into the park. And
fuck, no way.
Yeah,
is
I don't have it on.
Try?
I don't like, have it on.
Whales have you help you
camera,
skate
though?
Oh, you don't? No camera.
Nah,
no, footy.
There were my phone was dead.
Ah,
that's sick.
Dude, wait. So growing up in Washington, like when Twilight came out, was everyone just fucking hyped?
Oh yeah. I
everyone
remember
was like
my
a vampire.
Mom being super hyped about it, yeah. And there were like all these kids in like high school or not high school
pretending
but like
to be a vampire
in school that were like pretending to be a vampire and shit. They were like
you kind of
like
had
looking
that vampire
around and I'm just
line.
Like I remember just being like what the fuck.
You guys both have like vampire jawlines.
I didn't even like know much about Twilight either. I just knew about it because of my mom at the time because I was like still pretty young, but like kids would be walking around like fucking like acting like they're vampires or whatever. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Why is everybody like acting like this? Like, am I the only one that's not a vampire? What is going on?
Mom, I'm different than everyone at school.
Oh god, I'm outcasted, mom.
You're the one werewolf.
Yeah, I'm the one werewolf. God. Yeah.
How's 100 Thieves treating you? You signed with them, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you're signed with them
for gaming,
and now you're repping the. That's so dope.
Yeah.
And skating or just gaming?
Just gaming.
Nice.
In the announcement video, like I had to like act like mad nervous. Like so, I was like basically in the announcement video, like talking to everybody from 100 Thieves and like talking to different people in it. And for our clip with me and Valky in it, I had to act like nervous as hell. And I was like basically like in the video at the start, she's like playing a game on the computer and then turns around. I'm just sitting there staring at her like this. And she just like I'm like staring at her awkwardly and I start talking to her nervously. So I just look like I'm like tweaking. And it was like the most, it was like super awkward to shoot because I was like doing it so well that I actually like started feeling awkward about it. So and I was like, God, what the hell? I was like,
yeah.
Okay, this is getting weird. This is like how this is, and then I was like, I realized I was like, this is how I would like talk to a woman at a party. Like, this is how it goes usually.
Wasn't that how it like was supposed to come out?
Yeah.
Like, just super like nervous talking to
a girl. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And just like,
I'm the worst at that shit.
Like, going up to a girl at a party?
I have to be absolutely just, I have to have been drinking for at least 2 hours.
What's your go-to pickup line? Go-to pickup line.
Standing in a corner looking mysterious.
It's not really a pickup line.
No, it's not at all. I don't have
it.
Need
a pickup line?
No.
Yeah, you don't need
I was going to say the Weezer one.
Just like,
damn.
I thought it was, do you listen to Weezer?
Oh, yeah. Was, like, I have hit a girl with that once. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. It was a weird instance where like this girl came up and talked to me and I was like, oh, sick. I was like, I'm talking to somebody. And then like in my head, I was like, okay, I'm gonna chat it up a little bit. And then I'm like, first thing that comes out of my mouth, she's like, hey, what's your name? I didn't even say my name. And I was just like, you listen to Weezer?
Oh my God.
And then she was like, what? And I was like, never mind. And I just walked away.
That's so buddy. Damn.
I love Weezer.
I'm gonna try that with fucking the girl I'm dating.
Yeah, you should try it.
Listen to Weezer.
Yeah, that or just stand mysteriously.
Yeah. That brings them in.
Dude, the Moldavite?
Yeah, I was wearing like, I don't know about it that much, but I had like somebody had sent me like a crystal in a envelope wrapped in paper and it was a crystal necklace. And I was just like, oh yeah, for sure. I just threw it on my neck. And apparently it's like, I don't know.
Dude, no.
Okay. Super powerful?
No. So I don't have like the correct understanding of it, but basically it's like, from what I've been told, is it like people, it like gets rid of people in your life, right? Like people who like, I don't know, aren't helpful, I guess. But he was wearing it, he like got it and he was wearing it and we both went skydiving together and I was fucking terrified because I was like, oh, I'm gonna die. I was just like, this is how I die right now,
dude.
Yeah. Because of this stupid fucking crystal.
Wow.
That would be heavy.
And yeah. I was like, yeah, I'll take it off when I get home so I can place it down or whatever. But I just kept forgetting. And I just kept wearing it.
Wear it like, everywhere. For like
a month or two. Dude. And then I lost it.
Thank God.
Let's take off
Thank
the God. Fucking necklace gone. Before we go jumping.
Yeah. Yeah. Right?
Did you tandem jump, right?
Yeah.
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 I want to get my license out. It's just like is it one?
No, you said, instructor said it was a day.
Yeah.
To like get it?
6 hours.
It took me like. I went to Texas and got my license. It took like 3 days.
Okay.
Just because the conditions weren't like the best, but at least like 2 days for us out there.
I went too for one of the days. It was fun.
You was there. Yeah, you should get your license though. It's a thrill.
So you can fully go just like, just you, just hopping a plane.
Yeah, I have like 50 jumps by myself. What? Yeah. Dude, one time I jumped in Elsinore and it was sunset. And I'm with my buddy Vince and he's fucking nuts. He just like loves to jump. And they didn't have enough people to pack the plane, so they're gonna shut it down. He's like, no, fuck that. Like, here, whatever, I'll pay you to take us up there. So it was just me, him, and another friend, and the plane's just going like vertical straight up because there's no one in it. So we got to fucking our altitude pretty quick, and so we're jumping out. I jumped out and pulled my parachute, and as I was pulling like the toggles down to steer the parachute, I noticed that like the toggle was like in a knot, but like I still like yanked it down, just like fucking I was an idiot. And so that was tied, so I had no right steering toggle.
Okay.
I could only go left. And like so like the protocol with that is you're supposed to cut your chute and then like use your reserve.
Yeah.
And I was kind of just like low key panicking a little bit, but I fucking took it down. I just took a bunch of lefts all the way down and then I came in like with like a kind of like a crazy landing. And then so above you it's the risers, and so if you pull that, it kind of like stalls your parachute to land. But so I did that and I came in like all crazy and like I fucking get down and everyone's just like, what happened? I told them and they're like, you should have fucking cut. But like, thank God you didn't because we just saved the parachute. But like, that was fucking, it was gnarly. I couldn't steer at all. So
that's crazy.
Damn. If you fucking jump by yourself, make sure your toggle is good up there.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Damn, hell yeah.
Yeah, it was so stupid.
Dude,
have you seen like, those videos of those guys that throw the parachutes out before they jump?
And they fucking go get it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's insane. I also saw the one of the guy jumping off the hot air balloon where he has like a swinging rope and the rope swings off the hot air balloon and then he like does a bunch of flips in there and falls.
Yeah, it just launches.
It's crazy as shit.
Yeah, have you seen the one where the guy has no parachute and he's jumping from a plane into a net? He jumps like he's like fucking from like, I forget, like 10,000 feet. He jumps into a net, like a giant net.
And he's just fine.
Yeah.
Dude.
That sounds
fucking trust
stupid.
That.
Fucking nuts. Trust
I actually, that. I mean, I would definitely prefer, you know, doing this over bungee jumping.
What, skydiving?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I would definitely way rather skydive than bungee jump because there's something about like when you think you're that close to the ground going full speed and you think you're going to hit it and then like it pulls up.
And it just keeps happening.
Like there was something so peaceful and beautiful and like, my fear of heights felt like it was non-existent when I went skydiving that I can't explain.
Bungee jumping sucks.
Yeah.
It's fucking gnarly.
I'd rather jump out of a plane.
Yeah.
But I hate flying, so like...
So wait, did he make you jump out of the plane?
No. I mean, I'm down to go
skydiving. We mutually were like, let's just go do it.
Nice.
Yeah. It was fun.
Decided a day before it happened.
Yeah.
Do you guys have any like projects together besides like the skate video that you...
No.
...have coming out? No?
I mean, I work for you. Work for him. Yeah.
Teach him how to skate?
Did, yeah.
He basically has. I mean, like, when I was, like, learning or getting better, I was basically skating with him every day, so he's basically the one that, showed me how to skate.
Little coach moment.
What's your
little
role? Coach moment. Like, what?
Assistant.
Okay, amazing.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. Is he hard to work for?
No.
No? No. He just games and stays in, right?
Yeah.
So it's like...
Yeah, no, it's like...
like, so chill.
Yeah.
And, like, I ask him what food he wants, and he's just like... I already postmated it. Can you just get it?
Clearly, you're really good at like visualizing something and then executing and accomplishing it. So you got streaming, you've got the boxing, you've accomplished a lot on social media. What are some goals for yourself or things that you feel would be amazing if you were able to do next?
Well, I'm trying to go at like I'm taking like more of the path of modeling right now, like especially in the last few months. I just did a magazine cover for Tings, and then I just did I went to a fashion show for Dior. It was super sick. And I'm trying to go down that route more. I mean, in the long run, I think acting would be cool, but like I'm not the type of person to want to like, if I'm given the opportunity right now, I don't want to jump into it because I don't want to look like an idiot.
Yeah.
Like I don't want to just take an offer and like go in there and I look stupid. So I like want to like take classes and lessons and all that stuff before I do that. But as of right now, it's like I have so much stuff that's like that I'm doing that, you know, I'm going to have to like wait and see like which direction I actually want to go into and like commit to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So.
That's amazing, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah. The acting route's definitely fun. You should definitely tackle that when you can.
Yeah.
And like get a coach. Even like do some like Zoom calls, make it easier, you know.
Oh yeah.
But fucking Dior, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Have you walked for them or
Mm-mm.
No?
Mm-mm. I haven't walked for anyone, but
you're going to have Fashion Week though in a couple weeks.
Yeah.
Nice, dude.
That's cool.
Well, fuck, boys. Thank you for being on here.
Of course.
Any final words for the podcast?
I made up a word, by the way. I'm gonna make the word jaunch relevant.
Jaunch.
It's pronounced jaunch, but it's spelled J-U-N-J.
Jaunch.
Like it's just spelled differently J-U-N-J? And it's pronounced differently because I want it to be, and it means anything.
Damn.
Jaunch.
Real. You should get that tattooed.
Yeah.
Max, you want to get that tattooed today?
I have a tattoo appointment after this. You want to get a tattooed today?
I'm down.
All right, for real.
Is it the tattoo appointment around here?
You
have to go back home.
No, it's like in the area.
Nice.
Yeah, I mean, yeah,
fuck
jaunch,
jaunch
right here.
Jaunch.
What does it mean again? Anything?
Oh, yeah, I know you will.
Yeah.
This motherfucker would do it. Have you guys seen his tattoo?
Yeah, I showed him. We were talking about tattoos earlier.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Well, fuck yeah. On that note, this is the good boys, jaunch, fucker.
Yeah.
Ouch.
Jaunch.
Cue the music.